Hey everyone! Today's video is about some tips and tricks I use when I'm creating my digital journal spreads and any layouts in general. I'll be going over my thought process while creating my spread and what rules I like to follow when getting started. I'll also be sharing what apps helped me in the process and how to use them. Let's get started! The number one thing I keep in mind is most definitely color. Finding colors that work well together can really improve the look of the spread. One good rule of thumb is to choose a main theme color for the month and stick to colors that complement that main color. Adding small pops of color that work well together can make the spread look cohesive, even if the rest of the spread is relatively simple. This is why I create stickers using the theme color to get the spread started. I create my stickers on Procreate. So to bring a color from GoodNotes, I click on the color I'm using, click Edit, and copy the hex value. Then I open up Procreate and go to the Value tab and paste it. Using this color, I draw things related to the month. When I put it back into my spread, the colors match, so the sticker looks like it belongs there. But I want some more variety in my colors and not limit myself to just using one. How do you know which colors work well together? I honestly am not an expert with color myself, so I use tools to help me figure this out. The first tip is for when you just need a single complementary color to work with. Procreate has a built-in color tool that calculates which colors are mathematically supposed to work well with your color. But I don't always find that I like the colors suggested by Procreate, so I do need to adjust them sometimes with the value panel to get the look I want. This is a quick way though to get another color to pair with a main color. Let me introduce to you some other options. The next option is to search for color palettes online. Once you find a palette you like, you can sample the color and save the hex values to your note-taking app. To do this, copy the image into Procreate and simply tap and hold. The color will show on the top right-hand corner, and if you go to the Value tab, the hex value should be there for you to copy. Now you can go back into GoodNotes and add the color. Click on the pen tool and select the color menu, click on Edit, then the plus button to add a new color. Here there is a field to enter the hex value, and once you click back, the color should be added to your palette for you to use. Another way to do the same thing is to use colors from an image that you like. Adobe Color is a tool that generates multiple palettes for you from either a hex value or an image of your choice. I find that I like the color suggested here more than the ones Procreate recommends. To sample your image for a color palette, click Image and upload the image. On the left-hand side, you can choose between several color moods. There's colorful, bright, muted, deep, and dark. I love the purplish-grayish color sampled here. So let's take the muted palette and bring it into Procreate to sample the colors like we did before. Now that we have the colors down, let's take a look at how to use photos. The first tip here is to use filters to make your photos have a similar look. I took a quick photo of my desk here with my phone, and I'm copying it into GoodNotes by clicking Copy from my phone and pasting it directly into my iPad. Let's search for an unrelated but nice photo from Pinterest to bring into the spread. I'm using Pinterest in the web browser on Safari and not the actual app, because it is easier to save photos from there. Let's take this photo of plants and save the photo to Files. I use Visco to edit my photos, so let's filter the photos the same way to give them a similar vibe. I'm going to give my photo less contrast and more of a faded look so that the bright colors don't interfere too much with the rest of the spread. I'll save these settings as a recipe to apply to the photo from Pinterest more easily. Now I can open up the plant photo and automatically apply the recipe I just saved. This applies a filter, contrast, and fade I had from before. I'm also pre-cropping my photos into squares to make them fit perfectly into my monthly spread. Let's put the photos side by side. You can kind of think of this as an Instagram feed, where using the same filter on photos gives a more cohesive look. If you're not in love with how your picture was taken, you can also recreate your photo by tracing it to give that hand-drawn look. When doing this, you could also limit your drawing to the colors from the palette you selected before to make it fit even better into your spread. Since GoodNotes is a note-taking app, I do feel limited sometimes in what I can do with shapes and editing. So I use Keynote as a companion app when I do need something more, or just need a quick place to access my stickers. There's a bunch of stuff you can do with Keynote, but let me show you three features I use the most. Number 1. You can use Keynote to crop pictures to a shape such as a circle or a heart. To do this, copy and paste a picture from GoodNotes and draw a shape on top of your image. Pressing Shift on your keyboard or holding another finger down will help the circle maintain its proportions. Click and hold to activate multi-select, and select both the image and shape. You should see an option to mask with shape when you click on the arrow to the right to see more options. Click Done or outside of the selection, and you should see your cropped image. Now we can drag and drop the cropped image back into your spread. Number 2. Gradients. When you're feeling like some extra flair is needed, we can use Keynote to create a gradient. Click on the paintbrush and select the Style tab. We can then go to Fill and select the Gradient tab. Let's bring in some colors to use from the palettes we had before for the start and end colors. Keynote can sample these colors with the eyedropper tool. Click on Start Color and swipe right and find the eyedropper tool. Once we sample it, we can go back to the gradient window and see this new color in the recently sampled colors. Do the same for the end color. Now we can take this gradient and move it back into our spread. Number 3. One feature I really wish GoodNotes has is the ability to adjust opacity. We can do this on Keynote though, so let's create another square and click the paintbrush and find opacity. You can adjust this to make the shape more transparent. This is a great way to create some virtual tape, for example. We can copy this over to GoodNotes and do a freehand crop into a tape shape and put it on our leaves. Since journals tend to get very busy, especially towards the end of the month, ample spacing is very important to keep it organized and clean. Spacing gives breathing room to the elements you have on your spread to make it look less busy and more cohesive. Since it is so easy in GoodNotes to adjust handwriting size after you write, I often resize my handwriting to fit the space better. Also, keeping an eye out on the amount of spacing you have around elements and trying to keep things consistent will make your spread look even better. When you are just not having a good handwriting day or just want to add some extra flair, you can use some nice fonts. I recommend checking out Google Fonts since they have a lot of free quality fonts for download and they are all open source. You can search through different types of fonts and you can also download different weights. To install the fonts onto the iPad, I use iFont, which makes it really easy. After downloading a zip from Google Fonts, I import it into iFont. Next, I click Install and go into Settings to install the profile. After that, the new font is immediately available for use in GoodNotes. Let me just replace my hello here with the font we just downloaded. And we can also add a header to the circle image to give it a small accent. Alright guys, so those are some tips and apps I use when creating my digital journaling spreads. I hope you found these useful, and please comment down below on any tips you would like to share. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.